Hello world, I'm Brancliff. Right now, I am just doing some pet training, so if you're wondering why I'm in this completely random dungeon, now you know. I do plan on doing a pet training guide in the future, but as things are right now, I've got other things I need to do, like my 1,000 subscriber celebration video. This is the first video in said 1,000 subscriber celebration. In this video, I will be talking about what the celebration will be like overall and answer the Q&A questions that I asked for in my 750 subscribers video, which I actually posted exactly 1 month ago from the time of recording this. Today is March 8th, 2017, Women's Day, I guess, and last month, I posted my 750 subscriber video on February 8th, 2017. Although this probably won't be going up until a few more days, I'm recording this in advance because I want to be prepared for when the 1,000 when I hit 1K. So if you're wondering what the 1K celebration is going to be like, every day I will be uploading a single video. So one video per day, guys, woo, but these are going to be videos that people have been really waiting for a while for me to make. Oh man. Got that, like, hiccup there. Kind of like that slight hiccup, kind of hiccup, kind of gasp, where it's, like, not quite either, but it's a little of both. If that made any sense, it probably didn't. I will be posting one video every day, each of which is something that people have been wanting for a while. Not all of them are Elsword related. Some of them are actually just YouTube in general related. Most of them will have something to do with Elsword, because I will admit those are the only things I make that anyone actually watches. And I'm not going to outline what all of them are, but at the end of every video, I will say what is coming up next, so you guys will be prepared mentally for what that is. So in this video, I am going to be doing my Q&A questions. Now, I find Q&As to be a little weird, because if you ask me a question in my YouTube comments, I'll probably answer it anyway, so the idea of having an event where people can send in questions and I'll do something I would have done anyway just seems a little redundant. But every other person does it, so I mean, I may as well. And I guess that's kind of cool, because now the people who ask these questions will get their questions answered in video form, which is more likely to be watched by other people, because I don't know how many of my fans go through all my comments. I can definitely say I don't go through all the comments on any other YouTubers I watch, so I wouldn't blame you if you don't. And really, sometimes my comments are so dumb that I recommend you don't do that anyway. Now, I'm a little worried, because in the last video, I said that my dick is 13 inches long, and some people actually seem to have believed me. No, my dick is not 13 inches long. Have you ever went to Subway before? Have you ever ordered a foot long? Would you want to choke on a dick that was that long? I mean, I don't know. What are the girls into these days? Or maybe not just girls. I mean, it's current year, so I'm not allowed to judge. Holy shit. It's a good thing I'm home alone, because I'm not home alone. I mean, almost home alone. I talked about that in an Ostale video. But anyway, let's get to some questions. Let's see. Clifford Saba asks, Bran, can you read some Once Lure X Reader fanfics? So I'm already beginning this video with a shitpost. I could, but they would have to be on fanfiction.net because I refuse to go on Wattpad or AO3. And I mean, while I could, I'm not going to because I'm not in that fan base. Let's see. Smugly Main says, is there any efficient way to farm ED? I'm not a casher. I get my share of B bars from being a trap in game. Yeah, it's unbelievably easy to get free stuff just for having a vagina. This probably shouldn't bother me as much as it does, considering I'm a MapleStory player, and people do that on Maple all the time. The two most effective pickup lines on MapleStory being, one, I am an Asian girl, and two, I have a bishop. If you say either of these things, people will immediately give you head, but no, that still bothers me. But I will say, if you're wondering how to make money in this game, there are lots of ways, but usually a lot of them require some kind of beforehand preparation. Like, you could always play the market and treat all of the items on the market like stocks, because I mean, they kind of are. Like, buy advanced magic stones when they're cheap, sell them when they're not cheap. But I will say that that's a lot of work, because then you gotta memorize which items to look after, and you gotta, like, find out what the high and low prices are for them, and then you always have to prepare for the off chance that there's an event that uses them somehow. Like blessed enhancement stones, the prices that those go to during enhancement events are ridiculous. And then plus, you can't just look at one item because the prices on the market don't fluctuate that much. I know people like to shit on Elsword's economy, but it's not that bad. So that is a lot of work, and it requires you to do a lot of like mental work with it as well. So if you're wondering what you can do to make money in this game that is a little less mentally straining, to which I can't say I blame you, the two biggest ways are to do the things that you would have needed to do anyway and just make money off of them. For example, pretty much everyone is going to have to become a secret dungeon slave at some point for the purposes of either transcending, grinding resonance, pet training, or whatever. So while you are there, what you can do is you can pick up all of the barrier fragments and sell those. You could pick up all the sacrificed adventure items and sell those as well. You could pick up all the trash equipment that nobody likes, and if you're not using it for pet training for the purposes of making QPL jelly, which, by the way, it turns out that if you use the highest level QPL jelly when you're capped, it'll still give your pet more impulsive points. So, if you're capped, don't do that. But anyways, the trash equipment, dismantle those, and you'll get either compact weapon scraps or compact armor scraps. Sell those as well. I won't tell you how much they cost usually, because that's bound to change at some point anyway. And then that would make it so that my advice seems blatantly incorrect and also very misleading, so I don't want to risk that. But sell those, because people need those for the purposes of crafting their secret dungeon items, as you need compact weapon and armor scraps in order to craft the weapons and armor respectively. So just get everything from the secret dungeon and sell them. I have no idea as to like how much money you'll make or how fast that money will be made, but I will say it will make you money. If you want, you could also do Henner's Time in Space, which, you know, you do the run, and depending on how far you get in the run, you'll get a number of Time in Space crystals, which you can sell on the board, for a certain amount of money. I will say that the prices for Time in Space crystals has been dropping lately, so it might not be as fruitful as it used to be, but you will make money, and thankfully, Time in Space crystals actually sell very fast. And hey, who knows? Considering I'm making 4D equipment myself, I mean, maybe I'll be the person that buys your items. I've got a 4D top and 2D shoes. I don't really have much money right now though, so don't expect me to do it anytime soon. And even if I did buy your stuff, there's no way the game would tell you, so, I mean, it doesn't really matter. I got some, like, globby shit in my throat. So those are some ways to make money that don't require you to like think on it or anything. There are other ways to make money in this game, but they require you to either play the board and play the item memorization game, or you need to cash into it. Next question. Kenji Hadio asks, what bra size is your chung? Wow, hilarious. Did you eat a clown for breakfast to come up with that one? Got him. But I'm joking. Real question, what makes you keep playing Elsor? Are you still having fun? Well, actually, this is a pretty interesting question. Actually, a very good question, so thank you for asking it. But I do have a few things that do keep me tethered to this game, even if I wasn't having fun. I mean, I am, but some other things that I kind of have to commit to, like my guild. I mean, I kind of, you know, run it, so got a responsibility there. But I also have stuff like my YouTube. I will admit, while I do want to branch my channel out to other things, I will admit that Elsword videos are, like, the only thing that my fans watch, so I still gotta make those, and I have, like, 50 more guides to make. So don't worry, I'm not gonna run out of Elsword content to make anytime soon. Although, I am taking suggestions for guides if you guys have any questions on things that you feel need to be answered immediately, is what I would say if these guides didn't take, like, a month to make, which they do. But, I mean, I'm taking suggestions for guides, that's the point. I can't ditch my guild, although I said I would if MapleStory 2 came out in the Western Hemisphere. It seems that isn't going to happen, so I'm stuck here. Oh well. Hyrule Warriors Link asks, so is it possible you're going to post some sparring PvP videos, or maybe some type of room created once a week? That would actually be really interesting. Right now I only upload one Elsword video per week anyway, so if I were to do sparring videos every week, it would kind of get old, and people would be wondering where all the guides and the other miscellaneous entertainment are. I think when I'm more known as an Elsword YouTube personality, I would be more willing to do it, because as I am right now, if I were to make videos celebrating my, like, fame in the community, there was probably a less pompous way to say that. I guarantee you that at least some of the 7 other people that joined the room would have no idea who I am. Like, usually when a GM creates a sparring room, it says GM, so everyone knows, oh man, that's a GM, it'd be kind of cool to go in there. But right now, I'm just, like, a person on YouTube, so I could make a sparring room, and then not everyone who joins would know who I am. And then I'd have to explain it to them, and then they wouldn't really get a feeling for who I am until, like, I'm done making the video. And then, and, like, who's to say they'd even like my channel in the first place? But I will say sparring videos will be featured in my future Elsword videos, albeit for completely different reasons. I plan on making a Humans of Elsword video about sparring rooms, because I gotta admit, well, sometimes I go into sparring rooms and people have really stupid names for their sparring rooms, and I feel like a video needs to be made about that. Plus, I will say, if you go into the practice channel and you look at the names for the sparring rooms, there is some real freaky shit going on, usually in the form of roleplays. Sometimes you see roleplays that aren't that weird, like your average ordinary high school roleplay, but then you see things like, they'll put on like 50 genres at once, and it'll be like a room recruiting for a roleplay that's like fantasy genre high school made horror, and it's like, not sure I want to associate with that. And then sometimes you see some real freaky things going on. Like, I remember the one time I saw a sparring room that was an Aura named Futa Aura, and the room was called 1v1 Futanari Fun. And it's like, no, thank you. But maybe in the future, friendo. Cakey Pie Vid says, you should do a live stream on YouTube with Facecam and just have fun with it. If I were to live stream, I would do it on Twitch because it's more widely used for the purposes of live streaming, and I already have a few followers there. I actually don't know how many followers I have, but I have some, so that'd be kind of cool. However, the thing that's holding me back from live streaming in the first place is that I have a really not very strong rig. So, whenever I do live stream, there's always these awkward, like, frame skips. If you look at my Inset Aquarium video, oh man, you can see how bad it is. So, I guess if I had a better computer, I would. Right now, no plans on it. But it would be fun. Let's see. AquaDragon3 says, are you a potato? Suggestion. Get and Aura to level 99 and transcend. If not, then get an Eve PLZ. Give us proof you do it, PLZ. Thanks. I am not going to cap and transcend an Aura. Even if I wanted to do it just to give her a really shitty username, and then people could be like, congratulations, trash waste of a character on capping. I do have a transcended Eve. She's not capped, though. Her username is Gank Squad, and she's a Code Empress. So, there's that. Let's see. Star the Cat says, Bran, how wide is your destroyer? 14 inches. Please don't draw that. Whippy says, you still play Elsword? Yes. Raymond Heppner says, how can I get good? Like, how do you combo? How do you catch? Where can I learn these things? Please help me, I'm undeserving of my level 72 Reckless Fist. I won't PvP until I'm not a scrub. Alright, fine, I admit it. I don't know how King Crimson works. He erases time. But what does he, though, does he work? How does he Wormizen work? And then says, by the way, serious question, it just works and I fucking love your channel. I was actually planning on making a PvP guide. Although, I have the voiceover recorded, I just need to, like, actually make the guide part of it. But I will say, I should probably make a guide on it, because a question like that, that is too complicated for me to just answer in a video like this. I also have no idea how long this video is gonna be, but it doesn't really matter. It'll be as long as it needs to be. Let's see. Yuki Aya says, big fan of your vids, but what do you do in your free time besides playing MapleStory, Pokemon, or Elsword? Hope this gets answered. Big fan ever since I watched your guides, although I wish I could play an NA server and be in your guild, but I'm stuck in Int. I will actually say, and this is a little unfortunate, oftentimes when my fans join my guild, they don't end up sticking around for very long because they can't figure out how to get the member rank, or they're just not very talkative or whatever, which is kind of weird. I would think that if you're near your, like, YouTube idol, you would probably never shut up. But, and yes, I did say they can't figure out how to get member. There is a certain process to becoming a member of my guild, but some people can't figure it out. I'm not gonna say what it is. So what do I do in my free time? I guess I have other hobbies. Like, back before my YouTube channel was big, I did some stuff in game development, and, I've been slacking on that lately. I really need to get back on that. A magical life has been neglected, jeez. So that's a big thing. I also want to get back into singing. I have not done any singing in a long time, jeez. Like everyone else, I've got lots of hobbies. I just don't really talk about them as much. But thank you for following my stuff. It's really comforting to know that there are people who, like, super love my content. Let's see. Someone whose name I can't pronounce, and don't worry, it's not the guy with the bullet blitz tip. It's just another guy whose name I can't pronounce. He says, Brancliff, you should try Ring of Fury with Gates of Darkness accessories, spamming XZX combo that with Dread Chase, mate, you get 3 beads always. So when I record my videos, I have Audacity running to record my mic, and the game itself is being recorded by either Fraps, OBS, or the in-game recorder. It just depends on what I'm doing. Although I haven't been using the in-game recorder as much because it seems to be incompatible with my video editing program unless I run it through Handbrake, which is a program you can use to convert video files. My go-to choice of what program I use to edit videos is Camtasia Studio. Now, of course, it's no Sony Vegas, but it's very simple and it gets the job done. I don't really need anything too special because I'm not making, like, a sick MLG montage or anything. I just need something that gets the job done and isn't too complicated. I've been using Camtasia Studio for years, so I basically know it in and out, but for those of you who are new and willing to get into it, it may take a while. Although most of it is pretty self-explanatory if you've done video editing in the first place, it's your average ordinary timeline style program. I don't plan on doing tutorials for it though. I don't think I'd be doing a very good job at that. Plus they have tutorials on their website and in the help guide anyway. If you press F1, you can open up the help guide. Louis Zeno? Well, he says, when are you doing a TT guide? When COG stops making 5 rebalances per month, and when I get off my butt. Let's see, here's a question. From Indiana 201333, he says, here is a question. What do you think of My Little Pony Friendship is Magic? Note, if you never saw any episode from that show, you need to watch the first 3 or 4 episodes first before answering. Now, unfortunately, I have not seen the first 3 or 4 episodes, and I'm not about to go stop this recording, watch those episodes, and then come back to it. Come back to this recording, that is. That would be a bad use of the time that I have where I'm, like, almost home alone, but not quite. If you're wondering what I mean by that, I talk about that in an Austale video, but... So, I haven't watched My Little Pony Friendship is Magic, but I'm the kind of person who really judges the quality of a work of fiction by its fanbase, which means that I'm probably not ever going to watch it because I know that the fanbase sucks, and I know somebody's gonna be like, Brancliff, but you play Elsword, and, to that I have no response. Kinda got me there. So sadly I can't really give much input. I will say my little sister is what you consider a Pegasister, but she's not fucking obnoxious about it. She's not like an Undertale fan level of annoying, so there's that. He says, for 1,000 subs, you should do a top 10 Elsword and Miku Miku dance compilation that you like the most. I am not into, Elsword Miku Miku dance videos, or CM32D. Or El Rio Studio, so I can't really do much there. I will say, if any of you guys watch Yoon Girl, she's an up-and-coming Elsword Miku Miku dance video person, and I really like her work. She hasn't done very much of it because she's new, but what she has done I really like, so that's good. In fact, like, she did this one video, It was a dance video of an Eve in the wedding dress, and usually I really don't like Eves in terms of, like, waifuism, but she made the Eve look really cute in that video. So, I'm proud of her for that. Good job, Eunny. Senpai's proud of you. And, before someone asks, yeah, I did say waifuisms. If you're wondering what my, L-Sword girl tier list is, and, you know, maybe I should make this in video form later. Top tier is Aisha and Lou. Then there's Reyna, Luriel, Ariel, Rose, Eve, Aura, and then Elysis. And you might be wondering, wow, Brancliff didn't put Aura at the very bottom shit tier, to which I have to say, no, because with Aura, even if she is butt ugly in most scenarios, I can still recognize and accept that she is, in fact, a girl, and Elysis looks really manly all the time, so not gonna hit that. But I will also say, Elysis's hair belongs on, like, a L'Oreal commercial. It's beautiful, and I want to brush it all night. But I won't do anything more than that, because that's weird, and I don't like her like that. Also, now that I'm in town, I'd like to complain about something. After Humans of Elsword 2, I made a complaint video because someone jacked my fucking guild ad. And when I called them out on it, they kept doing it anyway. Our new guild ad is Free Brancliff Body Pillows, and I thought that I did a pretty good job in coming up with that one. But if you go down a few pages, and I say a few pages because I guess the guild leader hasn't logged in for this for a while, but, let's see. The ex-Hello Kitty ex-guild ran by Pluvia. They fucking jacked our guild ad too. Free body pillows of CL slash Snorlax slash booty. I thought I did a good job coming up with mine, but apparently I did such a good job that someone had to jack that too. Fuck all y'all. Let's see. Panda Waifu says, do a moe dance. You can choose any song you want to dance to, like Kyari. As cute as Kyari dances are, I am terrible at dancing, so I don't think I plan on doing that. Although I will say the idea of me dancing really badly and putting it on YouTube is probably something that everyone wants to see now. Especially most of my female viewers, I'd imagine, but I don't think I want to do that. Especially considering right now is when I'm having the stupid fights with the stupid, like, haters in the Elsword community. I think the last thing they need right now is more reason to laugh at me. So, not yet, but maybe when I've gotten to the point where I'm finally running out of Elsword videos to make, which definitely won't be for a while, and then I'm starting to branch out my channel to other things, maybe then I'll do, like, oh, wait, shit, maybe then I will do, dance videos, and maybe even singing videos, but as things stand right now, no. Ad Mastermind says, 13 inches, is that a joke? Yes. Yes, that's a joke. My dick is not 13 inches. Lest says, please teach me the arts of Chung, Bran. While I do sometimes play the other Chungs, I'm not good at them, and whether I'm even good at TT in the first place is debatable as well. I play with a very efficiency style play style, meaning that I loop Siege Magnum Shot a lot. When I play in Arena, it's without mercy because I have trouble winning, so... I mean, maybe. I still gotta make that TT guide. Okashi Poi says, solo heroic Herberon without auto party buff for the lulls. If you could still pick which heroic dungeon you wanted to do, I might think about it, but as things stand right now, there's no feasible way for me to do that, and also I would get destroyed. I've never once won that dungeon on Heroic, and I've won Atlas City on Heroic a few times, so I mean, I don't know, I think that's just something else. Anthony says, I feel like you should do a PvP video with commentary, that would be new. I could do that, but I would get really upset when I lose because of stupid bullshit, so I'm gonna pass on that one. Kaba123 says, Lamau, I just realized you told us your size. Sure. And then he says, how about a live stream on YouTube where you do 1v1s with subscribers? Oh, actually, that'd be really interesting. Maybe for, like, my 5k celebration. Hopefully I have a better computer by then, jeez. Wouter Crucker, it says, song parody. I've actually been thinking about doing that. When Season 3 came out, I wanted to do a parody of, Beautiful One Day, featured from Rhythm Heaven Fever. Sang by, Fuck it, I forgot what it's called. I might put something on screen if I'm not being a lazy piece of shit when editing this. But I ended up scrapping it. It was gonna be a song about being frustrated with PvP. And I wanted to do that again recently. Like, if any of you guys have heard the song, Cheap Thrills, you know, like, I forget the words, never mind. How did it go again? It was like, oh, I don't need dollar bills to have fun tonight. But, I wanted to do something like that, but instead of cheap thrills, it was cheap kills. And it's about, like, being a scumbag in PvP. But I decided not to do that because they've got this cool thing in the background in that song where they have, like, 50 kids shout, I love cheap thrills at the same time. And I don't have any way of recreating that. And I also don't have 50 kids with which to use. I was thinking of doing a thing on the forums where it'd be like, send in an audio recording of you saying, I love cheap kills, and I'll merge all of them together and then use that. And then every person who submitted an entry, I'd give them, like, some fucking meat or something, I don't know. But I ended up not doing that because I wasn't sure if it was gonna work. I really like the idea of musical parodies, so I do want to have some on my channel eventually, but they're very difficult to make, and I don't think they're coming anytime soon, especially with all the other things I want to make that are difficult to make, like my pet guide and my TT guide, which are still in, like, video editing hell. I'm sorry, everyone. But that was all of my 1,000 subscriber celebration comments on my that was my 750 subscriber celebration comments. So I guess this video is over now, but if you're wondering what comes next, then that is a very good question. I want to go back to the video that made me famous in, well, maybe not famous, maybe that's not the right word, the video that made me known in the Elsewhere community in the first place, because there are some things that I need to change about it that I should really do proper justice. I'm going to go back to the equipment guide, because there are still things I need to make about it. And if you're wondering when that is going to come out, it will be out tomorrow. So that is my Q&A video and the intro to my 1,000 subscriber celebration. I'm Brancliff. Goodbye, everyone.